Hi, I'm Dr. Rena Azar, and this is Dr. Susan Raschal, Dr. Suze. And today we're going to discuss an interesting and relatively newly discovered problem that people can encounter, especially if they're outdoorsy people.
Absolutely.
And that is Alpha-Gal Meat Allergy, also known as mammalian meat allergy.
Mm-hmm. So Dr. Azar is exactly correct that this is a fairly new allergy. In fact, it's been identified about maybe 18, 20 years ago. And what happens with this particular allergy, it can result in anaphylaxis. So let me review anaphylaxis for you. So anaphylaxis is when you ingest, come in contact with an innocuous substance that results in a potentially life-threatening reaction. And it can start with breaking out in hives or any kind of skin rash, and it can cause itching of your ears, eyes, mouth, and nose. It can cause you to sneeze. It can cause you to have breathing issues. In fact, majority of the cases, it's going to cause breathing issues. So that would be cough, wheeze, shortness of breath, chest tightness. And I mentioned again, uterine cramping can also be one of the signs of anaphylaxis. And GI symptoms, so nausea, vomiting, diarrhea. So those are the things that are, those are the symptoms or the signs associated with anaphylaxis. So most anaphylactic reactions occur because of proteins, and that has been well documented in the medical literature. This particular allergy is very unique in that it is due to a carbohydrate. And we wonder if that is the reason why, when most anaphylactic reactions or life-threatening reactions occur within minutes, this one occurs 3 to 8 hours mm-hmm. later.
And it's hard to identify because
of that. It's extremely hard to identify. In fact, we had labeled, before this particular Alpha-Gal allergy was identified, we would call those people idiopathic anaphylaxis. And in medicine, unfortunately, we have a lot of things that are considered idiopathic. And mm-hmm. idiopathic means...
I don't know.
That's right. She's right. Sometimes we joke about the word and say... patients, the doctor's an idiot because they can't figure it out, and the patient's pathetic because we can't help them, but we don't use that. But idiopathic essentially means we don't know. So one of the things that I did is went back to some of these old cases that I had of idiopathic anaphylaxis and brought them back into the office to see if they could possibly have this newly identified allergy. So Alpha-Gal allergy has to do with another unique component. One is that a person has this delayed reaction, and the second piece of this is that they have to have been bit by a tick. In fact, at this point, they have identified 9 different species of ticks that are responsible for triggering this anaphylactic reaction. The other interesting thing, again, is that it's a carbohydrate, not a protein, and that it's a delay. So sometimes what will happen is people will wake up in the middle of the night with hives, swelling, can't breathe, and they can't figure out at all what it is, and then they'll come into the allergist's office, and then we can ask that detailed history. Are you an outdoors person? In fact, one of the index cases for Chattanooga was a fellow who was an avid photographer. So he'd be out in the woods constantly, and he had multiple tick bites over the years, and noticed that he was having reactions to red meat. And so when he came into the office, we immediately checked him for a possible anaphylactic reaction to Alpha-Gal, and sure enough, he was positive. Mm-hmm. Previously, they didn't have a blood test, but now they have a blood test to help identify it. So anaphylaxis due to a tick bite, and what we have learned since then is in the saliva of the tick is this carbohydrate Alpha-Gal, or galactose alpha-1,3-galactose. We also discovered, in fact, early on, that there was a chemotherapy agent that was given to people for colon cancer, and it was cetuximab. And what they identified was many of these patients were developing these anaphylaxis reactions. And they identified, when they looked at the entire region of the United States, found that it was really localized to the southern area. And they were trying to figure out what in the world is going on with that. Well, it turns out that cetuximab has Alpha-Gal in it. So if a person was then eating mammalian meat after having had cetuximab or before, they could have an anaphylactic reaction. The other interesting thing that kind of pulled everything together was in Dr. Platt's Mills, his laboratory in Virginia, what they looked at is they thought there is something about this particular region. And so they looked to see where were tick bites. And they found that the heaviest influence of Rocky Mountain spotted fever occurred in this region, in central and south region. And they identified that there is a specific tick, the lone star tick, that was responsible for this particular allergy. Rena, please show us the lone star tick. I want you to get an idea of what this is, the female Lone Star tick, and she does have a little spot on her back. It's supposed to be a star, but that's the closest we have to a star. So that is our Lone Star tick. And again, next picture, please. The other thing that we identified was that it's not just the female that can cause a person, that can inject that alpha-gal into a person, but it can be all the different stages. This is how small it is. This is someone's finger, and you can see how small it is, which is why anytime you go out in the woods, you should be checking for ticks anyways because of other conditions. We mentioned Rocky Mountain spotted fever, but also Lyme's disease, as well as this alpha-gal allergy. Next slide, please. And then this is the different size ticks. And you can see this is a dime. So this is a 10-cent piece. And here is the mama, which is the female. Here is the male, a little bit smaller. Here is a juvenile. And then here is, and they call this the nymph, and this is a larval stage. And some people will say they've been bit by chiggers or other things. Now, it doesn't matter. What matters is that history. So if someone has had an anaphylactic reaction hours after they have eaten mammalian meat. And again, we talked about what's a mammal. So mammalian meat is going to include pig, milk, cow, so beef, as well as buffalo, caribou, a moose, anything that you can imagine that is a mammal. But those two things have to go together. The other thing that we have identified is that sometimes a person may not be eating meat, but they may be drinking the milk, who have had, again, the tick bite. Or there are some foods that contain gelatin. And remember that milk and gelatin come from mammals. So some of those folks had life-threatening reactions after ingesting those foods. So the question begs, okay, so now we know about that. What do we do about it? So it is emergency readiness. And the reason why you want to have that emergency preparedness is because this is one of those reactions that can catch you off guard because you have no idea. You're waking up in the middle of the night after eating a dinner at 8 o'clock at night, and you're waking up 8 hours later and you're in a full-blown life-threatening reaction or anaphylaxis. So you want to always carry that auto-injectable epinephrine. You also want to make sure that other people know where it is and what your condition is and be prepared to treat it and then get to the nearest emergency department. And remember, you always want to have two of those auto-injectable epinephrine devices together. Now, here's some good news. It can go away. So this allergy can go away, especially if you have not had a tick bite. It can go away. And some of the literature suggests it can last 8 months, it can last 5 years. But if you continue to have tick bites, and you continue to eat mammalian meat, well, unfortunately, you may continue to have this allergy. So those are some of the salient points that we want to talk about with regards to alpha-gal allergy or mammalian meat allergy.
All right, interesting. Interesting to note that it's an allergy that is predisposing people to anaphylaxis, a severe, life-threatening, potentially reaction. And it is something that has a very different profile. It presents differently, prevents the delayed onset, and it's region specific in that it's related to a history of tick bites and that it can go away.
So, oh, and there's something else that I did want to mention is that it has been identified in all the continents except for Antarctica and Antarctica, mm-hmm. and that the highest rate, it turns out, is actually in Australia. And an incredible researcher there and an incredible researcher here are the ones that are noted for identifying this particular allergy.
Mm-hmm. All right.
And that's it. Hashtag anaphylaxis, hashtag EpiPen.